We continue now at the top of Daf Ayin Beis Amud Aleph and Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 72a. The Mishnah said right at the beginning that if a person shechts a Korban Pesach on Shabbos, but he doesn't shecht it lishmo, he doesn't shecht it as a Korban Pesach, then the Korban is pasul, and that's considered a violation of Shabbos. So the Gemara asks, B'may Askinan, what exactly is the case over here? Why did this person shecht this Korban Pesach, not lishmo? Ilema bitoz, bitoe, if you're going to say that the person made a mistake, as Rashi says, kisavar shehu zavach acher, zavach acher, he thought it was a different carbon. He made a mistake. He didn't realize what he was shechting. So then, shamat mino akira bitoz, havi akira, should we learn from this that if you uproot a carbon by mistake, that's considered a good uprooting of the carbon? Meaning in this case, he accidentally shechted it for something else, and we're saying it's possible, it's not a good carbon Pesach. Shamat mino midaktani chayiv, it says in the Mishnah, you're chayiv, alma possible, who you see it's a possible carbon, because you're chayiv for violating Shabbos, that would imply that if you uproot a carbon from its original intention, but you do that by mistake, that really does uproot the original carbon. Ela ba'oker. So the Gemara says, you're right, we don't want to prove that. So rather, the Mishnah is on purpose. The guy purposely took a carbon Pesach, and you have to say the Mishnah means he purposely shechted it for some other carbon, and that's why it was uprooted from being a carbon Pesach. But if that's the case, that you're being oker it, so let's look at the end of the Mishnah. It said, "Ushar kol azvachim sheshachdan l'shum haPesach." It says, if you have other karbanas and you shech those as a karban Pesach, again, when erev Pesach falls on Shabbos, im einon ruuyin chayiv. So it said, according to everybody, if it's not fit to be a karban Pesach, so then you're certainly going to be chayiv. However, im ruuyin hein, if the animal that you're shechting could, at least in theory, it is the kind of animal that can be a karban Pesach, then it's a machlokus. Rabbi Eliezer mechayiv chatos. Rabbi Eliezer says you're chayiv chatos because, again, you bring a karban that's not docha Shabbos and you're violating Shabbos. Rabbi Yoshua Poter, but Rabbi Yoshua says, no, since your intention is to do a mitzvah, so you're trying to bring a karban Pesach, so you're what we call tov bedvar mitzvah and you're poter. But the Gemara asks, V'iba Oker, if you're saying that this Mishnah is talking about a situation where you're really being Oker on purpose, you're not making any kind of mistake. You're purposely trying to bring this carbon instead of bringing it what it originally was. You're trying to bring it as a carbon Pesach. So Mali Ru'uyin, Mali She'enan Ru'uyin, what's the difference if it's fit to be a carbon Pesach, if it's not fit to be a carbon Pesach? Why is Rabbi Yoshua any more lenient when it's fit to be a carbon Pesach? That wouldn't be Toa B'dvar Mitzvah. That would be taking a carbon, which you're not supposed to bring on Shabbos, and violating Shabbos. So elipshita betoa. Obviously, the safe of the Mishnah has to be you made a mistake. That's the only way to explain that it could possibly be toa bidvar mitzvah in your potter, according to Rabbi Yoshua. So now it's going to come out reisha ba'oker v'seifa betoa. The beginning of the Mishnah is talking about where you're uprooting it on purpose from one carbon to the other, and in the seifa we're talking about where you make a mistake. Does that make sense? Amar Rabbi Avin. Rabbi Avin says in yes reisha ba'oker. The beginning of the Mishnah is talking about when you're being oker v'seifa betoa. The end of the Mishnah is talking about when you make a mistake. Ashkechei Rav Yitzchak Bar Yosef l'Rabbi Avo. Rav Yitzchak Bar Yosef found Rabbi Avo to have a koi b'uchlus ha'de'inshi. He was walking with a large group of people. Amar Lei said to him, Masnisen Mai, what exactly is the case in our Mishnah? Same question that we had at the beginning of the Gemara. Amar Lei said to him, Reisha ba'oker v'seifa b'toa. The beginning of the Mishnah is talking about when someone on purpose tries to uproot the carbon Pesach, bring it as a different carbon. The seifa is talking about when you take a different carbon and by mistake, you bring it thinking it's a carbon Pesach. So Tana Minei Arbo in Zimnin, he learned this from him 40 times. V'dami Lei Kaman D'mancha B'kisei, was as if he put it into his pocket. He understood now what the Mishnah meant. And so the Gemara tries to bring a proof to this question from the Mishnah itself. The Mishnah said, Tanan, we learned in our Mishnah, Amar Rabbi Eliezer said, Ma im Pesach shemuter lishmo. If when it comes to carbon Pesach, which if you would have brought it lishmo, so kishashina as shemo chayiv. If you change the carbon Pesach, say I'm not bringing it as a carbon Pesach, I'm bringing it as something else, then you're chayiv for violating Shabbos. So zvachim, when it comes to regular carbonos, shehein asurin lishmo, which if you bring them as the carbon they're designated for, it certainly would be prohibited. Kishashina as shemon. So when you change it to a carbon Pesach, eino din shiyei chayiv. Certainly you should be chayiv. That was Rabbi Eliezer's argument. So the Gemara says, Ve'im Isa, if it's really true that the Reish is talking about where you purposely uproot it from being a Karban Pesach, and the Seifa is talking about where you make a mistake, so halo dami, you can't compare the Reish to the Seifa. De Reisha be'oker v'Seifa betoa. The Reish is talking about where you uproot it on purpose. The Seifa, the Mishnah, is talking about where you make a mistake. So what kind of argument is Rabbi Eliezer making over here? So the Gemara answers, no, Rabbi Eliezer lo shanile. One second. Rabbi Eliezer is making a perfectly good argument according to him. Because remember, according to Rabbi Eliezer, it makes no difference whether you make a mistake, whether you don't make a mistake. It's considered a violation of Shabbos. There is no difference. So Rabbi Eliezer can compare the Reish and the Seifa, because the Seifa can be equally talking about when you're oker or when you're making a mistake. But the Gemara still says L'Rabbi Yoshua, but still, according to Rabbi Yoshua, the Shani Le, who does make a distinction and says the fact that you made a mistake makes a difference, so Lishni Le Hachi. So Rabbi Yoshua at least should answer Rabbi Eliezer in that fashion. Rabbi Yoshua should say, what are you asking a question from the Reish of the Mishnah for? That's a case of Oker. But I'm talking about Toa, and Toa B'Dvar Mitzvah is Pater. So the Gemara says, Hachi Kamarle, no, this is really what Rabbi Yoshua was saying to Rabbi Eliezer. He said, Lididi, according to me, lo dami, they're not comparable. Reisha be'oker v'seifa betoa. The Reisha of the Mishnah is talking about Oker, the Seifa is talking about Toa. But Lididach, but according to you, that you say that there is really no difference, so lo imamrit bepesach shashina shemo ledavar aser. When it comes to Karban Pesach, you are trying to bring it not as a Karban Pesach, but your intention is to bring it as a Karban that you're not allowed to bring on Shabbos. So Tomar v'zvachim, so you're going to argue by the case of the zvachim by the regular Karbanos, shashina shemo ledavar amutter. There you're trying to change it to something which you are allowed to bring on Shabbos. The goal was to bring it as a Karban Pesach, which is mutter on Shabbos, so you can't compare the two. And now the Gemara continues with the next line in the Mishnah, Omer Le Rabbi Eliezer. Rabbi Eliezer says to Rabbi Yoshua another argument in his defense, Emurei Tzibor Yochichu, the Emurim of Karbanos Tzibor, they should prove the other way, meaning they should prove that in fact you're Chayiv, Shehin Mutarin Lishman, because for example, a Karban Tamid, a Karban Musaf, you can bring those on Shabbos if you bring them Lishman, if you bring them for the Karban that they were intended for. V'hashochet Lishman Chayiv, but the halacha is, if you take a different Karban and you say, I'm Shechting this as a Karban Tamid, or I'm Shechting this as a Karban Musaf, you're going to be Chayiv for violating Shabbos. So why is it any different when you take a different Karban and Shecht it for a Karban Pesach? That was Rabbi Eliezer's argument why you should be chayiv. Amar lo Rabbi Yoshua, so Rabbi Yoshua responds to Rabbi Eliezer in the Mishnah, lo imamrit be'murei tzibor sheken yesh lan kitzvah. When it comes to a murei tzibor, there's a set amount. You bring one every day or whatever the number is. Tamar bepesach, but look at Karban Pesach, it's totally different. She'en lo kitzvah, there's no set amount. As we explained when we did the Mishnah, there are people all over the place bringing Karban Pesach, so it's a completely different situation. This guy found an animal. Of course he can assume it's a Karban Pesach like the thousands of other karbanos that people are bringing. And that's why in this case, if he takes a carbon that really was designated for something else, brings it for a carbon Pesach, we call that Toa B'Dvar Mitzvah, and he's going to be Potter according to Rabbi Yoshua. So the Gemara now asks, L'meimor, does that mean to say, T'chol Heicho De'Islei Kitzvah, that anytime there is a set amount, Mechayev Rabbi Yoshua, Rabbi Yoshua would be strict. In other words, are we really saying that Rabbi Yoshua is only lenient by Karban Pesach, but all other comparable cases where there's a set amount, where there's not a thousands of karbanos or thousands of cases that are allowed, there Rabbi Yoshua would say you're Chayev. So we have a case that indicates not that way. Vari tinokos. There's the case of the babies with bris milah. D'yesh lan kitzvah, there is a set amount over there, and we're going to see that Rabbi Yoshua is lenient over there also. Utanan, we learned in the Mishnah. Misha hayu lo shnei tinokos. Let's say somebody has two babies. Echod lamulo achra Shabbos. One has to get a bris milah after Shabbos. V'echod lamulo b'Shabbos. One of them is supposed to get the bris milah on Shabbos. V'shokach, and the guy forgets. Umole shal achar haShabbos b'Shabbos. And he takes the one that really has the bris milah on Sunday, and he does that on Shabbos. So in that case, you're chayiv. Why are you chayiv? Because over there you made a mistake. You were taught b'dvar mitzvah, but you didn't actually do a mitzvah. So therefore, you're chayiv. This one was supposed to have a bris on Sunday. It's not even the time for the chiyuv of the bris. The Mishnah continues, Echod Lamulo Be'erev Shabbos. Now, let's say you had one baby was supposed to get a bris milah on Friday, Ve'echod Lamul B'Shabbos, and the other one was supposed to get on Shabbos. So now, when Shabbos comes, both babies really are chayiv in bris milah. V'shakach u'mole shal erev Shabbos B'Shabbos, he forgets and he makes a mistake, and he gives the bris milah to the Friday baby on Shabbos. So in that case, Rabbi Eliezer mechayev chatos. Rabbi Eliezer says you're chayev chatos. Rabbi Yoshua poter, and Rabbi Yoshua says poter. That follows the same logic in our Mishnah. He was taught bidvar mitzvah, but he did do a mitzvah. In the end of the day, he did give a bris milah to a baby who was chayev in bris milah. It was chayev on Friday instead of Shabbos, but there's still a chiyev over here. It's at least a mitzvah called duhu, if not more. And that's why Rabbi Yoshua says poter. But the problem here there's a kitzvah, there's a set amount, and Rabbi Yoshua is still being lenient. So Amar Rabbi Ami answers, Hacha b'may askinon, here in this Mishnah the case is, Kegon shekadam umoles shal erev Shabbos b'Shabbos. What happened was he took the baby who was supposed to be on Friday, and he did that one first on Shabbos. Di'ika hach the Shabbos de tarid beis. So the one that has to have a bris milah of Shabbos, the actual baby that's supposed to have gotten the bris milah today, is still there. He's still being tarred in this mitzvah. But hacha, but in our case over here, kegon shekadam v'shachtinu le'emurei tzibor bereisha, they've already brought the carbon tzibor. That's already been taken care of. So at the time, in this case, at the time you're bringing the carbon, this other animal, as a carbon tamid, when it's not really designated for a carbon tamid, the carbon tamid's already been finished. That's why in this case, Rabbi Yoshua says you're chayiv. But in a situation where, let's say by the bris milah, where you still have the baby in front of you that requires this bris milah on Shabbos, that's already a situation where you're tarred with that particular baby, and so that's why he says you're potter. So the Gemara says, if that's the case, ihachi, if so, Rabbi Meir Omer, look at the Mishnah. The Mishnah had a line about Rabbi Meir, where Rabbi Meir said, af ha-shochet l'shem emurei tzibor potter. Rabbi Meir said, no, yeah, actually, even in the case where you shecht an animal that's not the carbon tamid, let's say, but you bring it as the carbon tamid, Rabbi Meir said you're potter. So is Rabbi Meir saying, af agav dekodem v'shachtinu l'emurei tzibor bereisha? That would imply that Rabbi Meir is being lenient even where you shechted the actual carbon tamid, or the actual carbon tzibor first. Why would that imply that? Because if we're saying that Rabbi Yehoshua says only, specifically, Rabbi Yoshua and Rabbi Eliezer really are saying you're chayiv in a situation where shachtinu le'emurei tzibor bereisha. That's what Rabbi Yoshua is saying over here. The reason why it's a problem is because you shechted already the carbon tzibor. So then Rabbi Meir responded. He was obviously arguing with Rabbi Yoshua in Rabbi Yoshua's case. So Rabbi Meir said, you know, I say even in that situation, apparently that's what's going on. Rabbi Meir was saying, even in that situation where you already shechted the carbon tzibor, I still say you're potter because I still say at the end of the day, you were toa thinking that you were doing a dvar mitzvah. So is that really true, Vatanya? But we learned in a brisa, Rabbi Chiya may avil ariv, that Rabbi Chiya taught in a brisa, Rabbi Chiya from this place, this was a location, avil ariv, he taught the following brisa. Amr Rabbi Meir says, lo nechliku Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Yoshua, this is going on the case of the tinokos, so this is Rabbi Meir's understanding of the machlokus Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Yoshua by the case of bris milah. So he said, Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Yoshua, they don't disagree. They both agree on the following case. Al shahayu lo shnei tinokos, let's say there are two babies. Echad lamal erev Shabbos, one's supposed to get bris milah on erev Shabbos. V'echad lamal b'Shabbos, and one of them's supposed to get bris milah on Shabbos. V'shakach umola shel erev Shabbos b'Shabbos, he made a mistake. He did the one of erev Shabbos on Shabbos. T'chayiv, everyone agrees you're chayiv in that case. Al ma nechliku, what are they arguing about? Al shahayu lo shnei tinokos, where there are two babies. Echad lamal achara Shabbos, one you're supposed to give the bris milah on Sunday after Shabbos. V'echad lamal b'Shabbos, one you're supposed to give the bris milah on Shabbos. V'shakach umoles shal achar Shabbos b'Shabbos, you did the one on Sunday on Shabbos. To Rabbi Eliezer, mechayiv chatos, Rabbi Yoshua poter. Rabbi Eliezer, in that case says you're chayiv, and Rabbi Yoshua says poter. Now that, of course, seems totally backwards. Rabbi Yoshua says you're chayiv when you do the one on Friday and Shabbos, but all of a sudden when you do the Sunday one on Shabbos, you're poter, that one's not even chayiv at all. So that's what the Gemara asks. V'tizbur, is that logic? Is that logical? Ma'hosim de'lo avin mitzvah poter. In the case where it's a situation of Sunday, you didn't even do a mitzvah, you're poter. Rabbi Yoshua says poter. Heichad de'ka'avin mitzvah mechayiv. Yet in a case where you give the bris milah of the Friday one, where you actually ended up doing a mitzvah, because that baby was chayiv in bris milah, and you did it on Shabbos instead of Friday. There suddenly Rabbi Yoshua says you're chayiv. So the Gemara answers, Amri devei Rabbi Yanai. They said in the yeshiva of Rabbi Yanai, here was the explanation of Rabbi Meir's understanding of the Machlokas Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Yoshua. Reish, in the first case where everyone says chayiv, kagon shekadim umolat shel Shabbos be'erev Shabbos. What the guy did was he gave a bris milah to the Shabbos baby on Friday. He completely switched the babies, and so now when Shabbos comes, there is no baby in front of him that is chayiv in a bris milah. Now he goes ahead and he gives a bris milah to the Friday baby. And as Rashi over here explains, Amri devei Rabbi Yanai Reish kagon shenischalif lo esmol shel Shabbos be'erev Shabbos umolu be'erev Shabbos. He went ahead and he gave a bris milah to the Shabbos baby on Friday. V'adayin lo noda ta'u, so he doesn't even realize he made a mistake yet. V'savar shezeh omid shel Shabbos, and he thinks that the baby that he's doing today on Shabbos is the Shabbos baby. Really, it's the Friday baby. V'av agav detarid be deramya mitzvah alo kafim achshavta. Now, even though he thinks he's doing a mitzvah, v'gam osa mitzvah, and he's even doing a little bit of a mitzvah because this baby is chayiv in bris milah, afilo achi chayiv, he's still chayiv for violating Shabbos, mishum delo nitana Shabbos lidchos etzlo. Because at the end of the day, this particular moel, he has no baby in front of him that's really allowed to have a bris milah on Shabbos. V'seifa nitna Shabbos lidchos etzel shel Shabbos. Rashi is continuing to explain the answer here that the yeshiva of Rabbi Yana is giving. In the seifa, when he's making the bris milah on Shabbos, again, he's giving the Sunday baby the bris milah, and he's not doing the Shabbos baby, but at least there is a baby present in front of him that does require a bris milah on Shabbos. V'ta bidvar mitzvah pater, and therefore he is a toa bidvar mitzvah. He's in middle, there's a mitzvah in front of him, he just made a mistake. V'afilo lo asa mitzvah, and according to Rabbi Meir, even if he didn't actually do a mitzvah, He ended up giving a bris mila to the Sunday baby. There was no chiv at all in the Sunday baby. L'Rabbi Meir Patra, that's exactly what Rabbi Meir is saying. Rabbi Meir is saying is all that matters is your Torah bidvar mitzvah. It doesn't matter whether you do a mitzvah. So in any case, if this is Rabbi Meir's understanding, Torah bidvar mitzvah, even if you didn't do a mitzvah, but let's now transfer this case over to the case of the carbon tamid. Now, let's say a person shechts thinking that he's bringing a carbon tamid, but really this is not a carbon tamid. So nitna Shabbos lidchos etzel carbon tzibur. The reason why it should be okay is because other carbonos tzibur are in front of him to do. So Shabbos is nitna lidchos. Now, even if you have a situation where the guy already shechted a carbon tzibur, hare shakach, but the guy forgot. V'al yedei shetarud bezevach zeh biyamim sha'avru. V'yodeya shezevach zeh omid likarev nival v'shakach shekvar nishchet uwe murei tzibur. This guy forgot that the Emurei Tzibur were already brought. V'shachtan l'shmani takes this animal and he shechts it as a carbon tzibur. But that's why it's problematic, because in this case it's exactly the same as a situation where you had the baby which should have had a bris milah on Shabbos and you already took care of it. Now you have no baby in front of you whatsoever that's obligated in a bris milah on Shabbos. Therefore, Rabbi Meir said you're chayiv. So the same should be true by the Emurei Tzibur. If you have no carbon in front of you that's a carbon tamid because they were already shechted, so why is Rabbi Meir saying you're putter in that case? That should be the same as Rabbi Meir's explanation over here, and that should be a problem. Just like if you have a situation of bris milah where you do the Shabbos one on Friday and you have nothing in front of you on Shabbos that's really chayiv in a bris milah, and then you give that one a bris milah, everybody agrees you're chayiv. Rabbi Meir should say the same thing is true by the carbon tamid. If you took care of your carbon tamid already and everything in front of you, there's no carbon in front of you that's a carbon tzibur, so then if you shech this other one as a carbon tamid or whatever carbon tzibur, you should be chayiv. We'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Ayin Beis Amud Beis.